Good morning, my reader friends. My name is Erin Rogoff, and welcome back to my BookTube channel. Today, we will be discussing Dangerous by Nora Ash. This book review does include spoilers, so if you don't want any spoilers for this novel, click off the video now. Otherwise, enjoy! Dangerous by Nora Ash is a contemporary fiction dark romance novel. It is a mafia love story, and it is so worth the read. I implore you guys to read it. This book is book one of the Made and Broken series, and in that series we have Dangerous, Monster, and Trouble. Readers who read this book also enjoyed Corrupt by Penelope Douglas, I have this book, Dark Twist by Tana Blaze, and this one, also Den of Vipers by K.A. Knight. I have this book too, and it is on my TBR list as we speak. We have two main characters, Blaine, who is the male lead, and Mira, who is the female lead. In the point of view of Blaine, I hurt, I break, I kill for a living. The family points, I deliver. This time, though, they ask for too much. My family wants me to marry the one woman who knows my secret. She has reason to hate me, but I'll take her, break her, and make her mine. That's the only way I can keep my secret. In the point of view of Mira, I ran away 8 years ago and thought I'd escaped the underworld I had always known. I made a life for myself, I was free, but then my past came knocking at my front door. Now I'm marrying the son of London's biggest crime family, a man who hates me as much as I hate him. He's ruthless, brutal, dangerous, and he is everything I have always feared. He's taken away the life I've built for myself, along with my freedom and my sanity as well. How else could I have ended up pregnant with his baby? This book grabbed a hold of me and would not let me go. I started reading it in the morning, and by the late afternoon, I was halfway done with the book, and I finished the book by 1:30 p.m. the next day, and I consider it a very addictive read, and it's also free on your Kindle, so go check it out. Despite Blaine's arrogance, he is attractive, and I do admit that he does look the part of what I am drawn to in a man, and it isn't just his looks that I am drawn to, but certain personality traits as well. I mean, he's tall, muscular, he has dark hair, he has gorgeous eyes, he does have a few tattoos, which I seem to like. He is very confident, demands power, he's dangerous, and he has a very dominant personality, not just in life, but in the bedroom as well, and it doesn't take me long to fall for a fictional character, and believe me, I have fallen for this fictional character. I also loved the first easy conversation between Blaine and Mira. Blaine remembered that Mira had always wanted a horse, and he delivered on that dream of hers, which I thought was so romantic. I also enjoyed how Mira sat in on a meeting between Blaine and a rival family, then saw that the guy was playing Blaine, and she saved him from making a huge business mistake that would have ended up with his father being so mad at him that he would probably get beaten up. So, good job, Mira. You have great people reading skills, and considering I am one who doesn't have that, I respect that in a character. I also knew that there was a reason that these meetings with rival families would play an important part later on in the book, and I was right. I also thought that this whole scenario was dark and sexy at the same time, so let me explain. Blaine asked Mira to sit in on a meeting with another crime lord and his son, who were actually Mira's dad and older brother. Mira nearly broke down in tears after seeing the two men who gave her the scars on her stomach, but Blaine got her out of there, asked her about her past, and then he said that she was the strongest woman he had ever known, which I thought to be sexy AF. Also, to quote Blaine on Mira's past trauma, "They are battle scars, Mira, proof of how strong you are. They just make you even more beautiful," which I thought was absolutely gorgeous in that scene. What he said couldn't have been better if I had written the book myself, which I would never be able to do, because I can't write a dark romance novel. I've tried, it doesn't work. I also really enjoyed how Blaine and Mira went back into the meeting together, and then Blaine totally owned his father-in-law and brother-in-law by cutting all ties with them and ordering them out of the city. That was badass, and I totally loved that scene. Also, when Mira's brother called her a whore, Blaine defended her and was all, "Don't you dare speak to my wife that way." And that was just another sexy AF scene. I loved that. I could reread that scene over and over again and never get tired of it. I rave about this book. Sexy, brutal, intense, moving, addictive. I could simply not put this book down. I read it in a day and I want so much more. This book is totally worth swooning over and obsessing about. Kudos to Nora Ash for writing such a wonderful book. Amazon rates the book 4.3 out of 5 stars. Audible.com rates the book 4.4 out of 5 stars. Barnes & Noble rates the book 4 out of 5 stars. Goodreads rates the book 3.9 out of 5 stars. And my rating? 5 out of 5 stars, hands down. This book is 298 pages and will take about 3.5 hours to read. This was one book that I was completely obsessed with from start to end. This book is not meant to be read by kids, but I would recommend this book to fans of dark romance or taboo romance novels, fans of mafia love stories, fans of kinky love scenes, readers who enjoyed the 50 Shades of Grey series by E.L. James, and the types of readers who enjoy underrated romance novels, which this was. Will I reread this book? Yes, absolutely. No chance in heck that I won't let this be the only time that I will reread this fantastic book. Oh my gosh, I highly recommend it to all of you guys, and I can't wait to know what you think of the book as well, because I would love for you to tell me what you have in your own opinion about this book. Is it good? Is it bad? What do you think of it? Is this book recommendation good for you? Let me know in the comments below. Anyway, that is all for today, so if you enjoyed this video, hit that like button to show some support, subscribe to my BookTube channel to get more videos like this, turn on those notifications to be notified when I have a brand new video uploaded, keep on reading, and have a great day, everyone!